This is London calling in the North American service of the BBC.
Here, a few feet from where we're standing, in the very same old vagonly railroad coach where the armistice was signed, on that chilly morning of November 11th, 1918, negotiations for another armistice, the one to end the present war between France and Germany, began at 3:30 p.m. German summer time this afternoon. What a turning back of the clock, what a reversing of history we've been watching here in this beautiful Compiègne forest this afternoon. What a contrast to that January 22 years ago. Yes, even the weather. For we had one of those lovely warm June days, which you get in this part of France, close to Paris, about this time of year. As we stood here, watching out our Hitler and Field Marshal Goering and the other German leaders laying down the terms of armistice to the French plenipotentiaries here this afternoon, it was difficult to comprehend that in this rustic little clearing in the midst of the forest in Compiègne, from where we're talking to you now, an armistice was signed here on a cold gray morning at 5 a.m. on November 11, 1918. The railroad coach, it was Marshal Foch's private car, stands a few feet away from us here, at exactly the same spot where it stood on that gray morning 22 years ago. Only, and what an only it is, too, Adolf Hitler sat in the seat occupied that day.
Guards. He said, okay, fine. Anyway, so we worked it out. We got extra pay, was $125 a day. Wardrobe was $25. Accoutrements was $25. The guys got $175 a day. And David came to me later and said, what, have you negotiated for all of it? I said, that was cheap, David. Cheap. And he said, yeah, but that's better than what we've been getting. He said, we should have you negotiate. So like I said, on this deal here, if they do decide to do that, put it right in the contract that they get to be part of the German army. If the one guy wants to be the technical advisor, he gets to be the technical advisor. I mean, you know, there's always concessions. It's what's called a deal sheet. It's not a contract. They don't like the word contract. But a deal sheet, in all fairness, you can break a deal sheet too. But sometimes you can break it to your favor, or sometimes they can break it to their favor. But you just got to know what you're doing.
That he had not chosen this spot at Compiègne out of revenge, but merely to right an old wrong.
Ladies and gentlemen, the news which has come from Montevideo has been received with thankfulness in our island and with unconcealed satisfaction throughout the greater part of the world. The pocket battleship, Graf Spee, which has been for many weeks preying upon the trade of the South Atlantic, has met her doom. And throughout a vast expanse of water, the peaceful shipping of all nations may, for a spell at least, enjoy the freedom of the sea.
We have yet to see a German plane over the amphibious convoy, which doesn't necessarily mean that we shan't see them before the attack is over. Our air support has been fine, and the loudspeakers call out almost constantly Spitfires on the porch, or Mustangs overhead, or B-17s passing on the starboard side. And as far as I know, no report has come in of attack by a Nazi sea craft onto the convoys. Now it's almost black dark, and you see the ships lying in all directions just like black shadows on the gray sky, some signaling out to sea, sheltered on the inside from the Germans' eyes, signaling with red lights, blinking code. There are four fires on the shore, looking like pinpoints, winking, smudged by smoke. Now planes are going overhead.
Do you want to talk a little bit about your unit?
No. You want to... You know who our PR guy is Tim there. He'll talk for 5 hours if you will.
Friday, August the 16th. With the great air raids of yesterday and last night only a few hours past, it is reported this morning that German bombers and fighting planes are again over southeast British coastal towns. Berlin says a renewal of the attacks awaits only clearing of mists over the channel. In Rome, the Italian High Command says British planes raided North Italy again last night, but there are no details. But now the news direct, as reported by Columbia's correspondents in London and Berlin, following which there will be an analysis of the news by Linton Wells. First, the report of Larry Lesueur from the British capital. Go ahead, London.
This is London. I am speaking from a crowded air raid shelter, 2 floors underground. This morning, large forces of German bombers are continuing their unprecedented attempt to bomb England. We do not know yet how many more planes the Royal Air Force have added to their record score of yesterday, when the Air Ministry announced that the RAF had destroyed.
Here's what you will be eating.
There's going to be another Cooper's Farm this year.
We think so, yeah. We're planning on it.
Wait, you're Jeff Scott. I didn't recognize you from the beers.
One family, five kids. All around our
family. Hey, you go host.
Oh, what do you
want? Mike just went to the John and I'm going too. So, make sure no one steals the store. Thanks. Hey, what you watching?
Members of ENSA have entertained in the last few months officers and gallant men on the hood. You will feel as I feel about their last great gallant sacrifice. But the British Navy has in all its decades of history taken good care to avenge things of that kind. And that is why this morning at 11 o'clock the Bismarck was sunk.
This is me, one American soldier. My dog tag numbers in a minute. My draft numbers came out of the hat in every state in the Union. I'm from Janesville and Little Rock, Monroe City in Nashville. I'm from Blue Eye, Missouri and the sidewalks of New York. I'm from the Green Mountains and the Big Sky Hooten Plains, from the roll of the prairie and the rocks of Marblehead, from the little towns where a dog can go to sleep in the middle of Main Street, and the nickel-plated suburbs and cities that stick their skyscrapers into the sky. But I'm a soldier now, born 500,000 of us by the end of this year. And we're not writing letters, Adolf. We're on the job. We weren't picked out for our looks or Nordic names. We weren't picked out to hile heels that chew up small countries that never did us any harm. We weren't picked out to sit around on our parking spaces and wait for you to be nasty. Let me tell you a few things about us, about the kind of army we are. They won't make you happy.
In the part of Ohio I come from, lots of people have religious convictions against war. I keep these prayers at the back of my mind every day and believe these prayers. I pray for peace. But I'm not so much like those people in Ohio as I used to be. My convictions are that war is evil, and that the evil men are those who started it. When you ask me what I have personally to be angry against the Nazis who attack, that is my answer. They have hurt me and my people by making us fight a war that in our religion is bad. I don't know if I've made myself clear, but Hitler is my personal enemy, and I aim to stop it.
Obstürmt oder steigt, ob die Sonne uns sagt, der Tag liegt in Heiß oder Eis. Staub sind die Gesichter, doch der Flor ist unser Sinn, ja, unser Sinn.
Explosive grenades. 28. He's got a Jap bayonet on his pack. P-41s, boondockers, an M-19, 1918, French knife, trench knife. Storm that hill.